Hello, this is EvaGuy019, and welcome to another episode of Super Mario Bros. 3. Last time we left off, we did about one half of this world, and now we're gonna finish the rest, hopefully, and without much problems. Though I'm kinda doubting that would happen. Oh gosh. Okay, so I might have been playing Super Mario World mod before playing this, so controls. Playing this game is gonna be a bit confusing for a bit, because the controls are. Oh, dang it. The controls are noticeably different. Well, I would say that was a waste of star, except stars literally last like 5 seconds when you get them as a power-up on this game, so. Alright, I think I'm getting used to things already. Also, I don't recall 100%ing this world very often whenever I come to play this game, so some of these levels aren't going to be that familiar to me. But hopefully they aren't too bad. I could use kind of a chill session. There we go. I'm just curious if I'm gonna be able to get there without gaming over, because my lives are kind of running low. Hello, we meet again. Alright, we have three more. I think we can do this. I haven't even seen that. I guess not. Oh well. Yeah, without the hammer, or I don't think I could get to the boat, and without the boat, I don't think I could get to that island over there. Which again, I'm not sure if getting the item rooms also counts as 100%ing of the world, but we shall find out if I get that notification at the end. If I manage to complete the world, that is, without any problems. Okay, I think I remember this fortress. I don't think it's that bad. At least, not as dumb as the previous fortress. Funny enough, I don't really see these sprites in other Mario games very often, if at all. Do you know you could kind of use them in Super Mario Maker, which I think that's cool. What a joke. Okay, well, if I game over, I at least have a checkpoint right here. Let's try to earn our lives. That'd be nice. Oh, I think I did it too early. Dang it. Okay, well, something I noticed I didn't do at all, actually. I noticed I didn't use the frog suit at all. Which is funny, because I say it's one of my favorite power-ups in the game. But I'm just worried about losing it right away. And I didn't think Boss Fest makes his return. Hey. Funny, in the Super Mario World mod I was playing, I was just dealing with it. I was just playing a level to where he was involved, and yeah, it's pretty much confirmed that he acts quite a bit different, and it's quite a bit different compared to this game. He acts different in the mod compared to this game. He's faster, and in some cases he's invincible, which isn't really cool. As far as I did that. Please give me a 1-up or something. Yeah. Yeah. That's awesome. But yeah, I haven't used the frog suit yet, and I do want to use the frog suit eventually. I just kind of want to savor this power up because it's. Get away, Koopa! Okay. Because it's the first power-up I've gotten in a while that I haven't lost. You know, I'd be lying if I said I was surprised that happened. Yeah, those guys are not annoying at all. Yeah, I knew the second I started talking about having a power-up, I'd lose it. That's why I didn't want to talk about it. Oh well. Not like fire flowers are that hard to find anyways. Oh my gosh. I'm totally screwing up my controls right now. Okay, I think what's confusing me is I have to grab with the same button I'm jumping with or something, or I have to grab with the button I'm not jumping with, I think, something like that. And then I forget which button I'm using to run. No, okay. I'm grabbing at the same button I'm running with. And then I tend to forget which button I'm... Did I get it mixed up? I'm just confusing myself because I'm more used to playing Super Mario World. There we go. We might actually finish this quite a bit early. It's only been going on 10 minutes, but not quite. Okay, there's the what's over here? Yeah, there's not much else left to do on this side, I guess. Oh, let's go to the fortress. Wait, did I just go the same? Yeah. Maybe we'll start a little bit of World 4. Out, frog it out. There's really no point in using the frog suit for this level, but I think it's kind of funny. I also don't remember how many frog suits you're given throughout the game. I know, I think World 2 gives you them the most. No. See it again.
mia!
I should just quit my life. Cannot believe that happened. Actually, I can't believe that happened, but it doesn't change the fact that it was quite sad. Way to make it for a perfectly good frog suit go to waste. I'm not even sure what happened right there, to be honest.
Just what I needed.
I think I was just okay. That airship kind of rose with me, and she jumped right into me. Seriously. Okay. Well, I think we're gonna game over. Okay, I was really overthinking that fight, it wasn't that bad. I just really don't... really never been that good at fighting the Koopalings on this game. Because they kind of move a bit weird sometimes. But we did it, and with one life to spare. But I'm not quite ready to call it quits yet. Alright, so it looks like it still counts. Awesome. Yeah, because that would kind of suck that you lock it. You accidentally lock yourself out of 100%ing because you used the hammer in the wrong place. But, I think we're just going to call it. Kill myself. So my life restore. I'm actually quite used to seeing that, because, like I said, when I was a kid, I was really bad at this game, so pretty often. But at least it was our first game over was willingly. I didn't actually try to get a game over, so. Anyways, welcome to World 4, which is the giant world. And also, another one of the highlights of this game. It's a pretty fun world, which I don't recall it being too hard or too long. And I'm not going to do all of it. I'm going to do some of it, because you'll see in the future. But yeah, let's get started. So, in other news, I've been playing, I joined the Pokken tournament train and managed to buy it the day it released. And I have to say, it's a pretty fun game so far. You probably didn't know this, but I'm not a fighting game pro or anything. I'm definitely not a pro. In fact, I'm pretty terrible at fighting games. But I at least have experience of playing them, and I like them a lot. I just don't really ever have the time to sit down and learn them. At least some of them. Some that are more technical than others. So, yeah, I was excited to try Pokken Tournament because it's different. It's not your normal Pokemon game, definitely. Oh, I thought Boss Bass was here again. It's gonna be like, go away. Actually, I think he might be here. I don't know, I don't remember. I actually got that. Too bad I didn't get the power up. But yeah, Pokken Tournament is really fun so far. And I can expect some content of the game on my channel sometime soon. I was in a super rush to go online and get my bike kicked because it actually takes... Oh, wow. Power-ups just want to avoid me today. But, it takes... Oh, no. I guess this is why they gave me that star. I didn't know they'd be here. And look who wants to block the way. What happened? What a jerk. He just comes and blocks away and then leaves like I'm nothing. I have to say, I'm really not good at this game, but I think part of that is mainly because I am way more used to playing. Don't! Freaking seriously! But I think that's because I'm way more used to playing Super Mario World. Super Mario's physics, which arguably, in my opinion, has some of the best physics in a Mario game. Like, you can pretty much jump, run, and then do anything as you will. This game, your physics are a bit more slippery and limited. So, transitioning from Super Mario World physics to this physics is a bit confusing, but I'll get used to it. Especially if I want to get through the later worlds. But yeah, I was saying, you can expect some Pokken Tournament footage for me pretty soon. probably later this week. I've been trying to practice and get better because I don't want to get completely bought in online. It's not like with Smash Brothers where I went online day one, because I actually been playing Smash Brothers my whole life, so I'm kind of used to. Each Smash Brothers has been different, but I don't know. It's like once you play one of them, you're kind of familiar with how the game works. You just gotta get used to the fundamentals of the current game. So, yeah. Alright, well, I think that's good enough. So, yeah, I guess I'll end it here. This is EvoGuy019, and signing out. Have a good night, you guys.